good touch, run away. I got good punch, carbon back. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, right up. Easy pop, where you they go, go, you they go up. Catch my gun, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. Tina watch, now she wanna give. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the card. Man a real life, sugar gal and mafia get what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lens the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that ting. Any girl you want, they want my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, run away. Like I don't touch, grab my back. Like I'm so tough, like I lose trust. Quiet wrong, busy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough. Flood my eyes.
Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision.
Ready? You ready to fight?
All right, folks, here we go with round one. This is not the Eddie Bravo Invitational. This is the UFC, and two of the more decorated Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belts we have in this or any division.
Yes, in any division. We've never seen guys incorporate jiu-jitsu into fighting as we've seen this one. But who's going to make a mistake? Who's gonna leave an arm out there to get grabbed? Who's gonna leave their neck out? Let's see when you put two great jiu-jitsu players together, who can get their hand raised in the octagon.
And they both stand up. Out of range with that one. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the every part of himself into these big leg kicks. Oh, big punch land. Massive knee to the body land.
Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC. Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
Hard shots landing on both sides here. Kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. He's coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
Oh! And they separate. 2 minutes now to go in the round.
Score with the takedown.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick. Leg kick.
Just unable to quite find that range.
You gotta check these low leg kicks.
Got the single collar tie.
What a punch.
Oh, and the ankle hit to get him down. We'll see if he can capitalize.
Got the ankle kicks. Let's see how he advances from this position. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Right back up.
I mean, what an ankle kick. If he would have drove into his opponent, maybe he would have secured the top position.
5 minutes in the books.
That wasn't a bad run. That wasn't a bad run. Could have gone either way. Look, you tell the ref and he kicks, right? You can see him coming a mile away. Okay?
All right, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him. over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
How about that shin? Oh, vicious kick to the outside of that lead leg. You gotta start checking these, man.
Check these kicks, or you're gonna be limping around the octagon very short.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Get you. Hey.
Well, he continues to offer up the kick here, but just misses with that one. And there comes the separation now. Punch coming, it's blocked. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting. Bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find some more strike to end the night.
Well, he has certainly found the range and staying pretty busy here on the feet.
He's being busy, but it's also the timing and the accuracy that's allowing him to land so many attacks.
And they separate.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
Section. Gotta think his opponent's gonna feel that one in the back.
And he's gonna continue to throw that strike because he knows that his opponent can't take many of them.
Well, he was a little bit lackluster in round one. You can't say the same here in this second round. He has really picked up the pace, an uptick in the aggression and the output, and starting to find his range here in the pocket. Oh, goes to the ankle pick now to get him down, DC. We'll see how he chooses to proceed from here.
Got the ankle pick. Let's see how he advances from this position.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Allows him to get right back up.
He did a great job securing that ankle pick, but did not react quick enough to secure top position.
All right, so just like that, back to a standing position. We will see who has the advantage. And he continues to work the body here.
He lands a big knee to the body.
Back to the overhand left, no good. And he landed the right hand there. Oh, a huge block there. Oh, lands a stiff punch there, nice connection.
Oh, nice land. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Fantastic takedown.
All right, going for a single leg takedown here. That is usually his takedown attempt of choice and works out for him there.
Absolutely. He is.
You're striking is got you here. And you're striking is what's going to get us out of here. All right?
You ready to fight? You ready?
5 minutes to go.
Look at the whip action that comes through.
Oh, nice trip to change the level. All right, stacking them up here, keeping the pressure on. I know you guys do a lot of this training with your jiu-jitsu coach there in San Jose.
Oh, absolutely, but it's a difference. If your feet are on our hips, it's a problem. So we shove them through the middle. We shove them through the middle so that our legs can be what controls your feet.
Right.
We're not using our hands. I'm not using my hands. I'm using my legs to just kind of wheel and deal you from side to side. Then my upper body is free to punch.
If
you
can... Now, oh, and a quick entry.
Great single entry. Rotates the high punch, taking full right. They flip him over the top. What a fantastic takedown.
Welcome to the Cormier Express. Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop
you. Got to defend. But you can see him now starting to gain posture. And the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate. Knows then he can get the finish.
Well, no problem getting inside to land that straight punch. He's got a huge edge in reach, and he made good use of it there. Well, there's a takedown attempt. No surprise that he would go for it there, but unable to get the fight to the ground.
Whenever your opponent knows that you're going to try to take him down, you have to disguise it. He did not disguise it. He tried to shoot a blind shot and got defended, as you would expect it to.
Oh, he's landed a high number of total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds. All right, single collar tie now.
Right hand punch to the clinch.
Both guys really throwing with a full shot right on the mark.
That is the most debilitating shot in all the fighters. It is very difficult to recover from that.
Big knee to the body. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie, and they separate.
Great punch.
Oh, feints upstairs and lands flush to the
body. They land perfect. That is the reaction you're hoping to get. That one landed perfect in this fight. They can stop very soon.
All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie, and they separate. Right punches there. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to strike. Oh, a violent strike to the body. This could be the end.
I mean, this fight is close to being stopped. That was a massive shot to the body.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
On the shot. There you go, single leg.
Knee to the body. All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off. Boom, body kick right there. Landed perfect.
How the judges saw it. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges scored this contest
30-27.
Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, the Sniper.
All right, congratulations.